question now is what to do. Where to go with this global story and the seemingly devastating situation we're in? How to live in the world that Rastafarians call Babylon? The planet has been bought up, its resources transformed into virtual currency, and the roots of this Babylonian project are dug deep into the origins of our culture. Is there a way to reprogram the source code of this terminal civilization? Can we break out of the gilded cage? The metaphors abound and the imperative for change is strong, but the magnitude of the task is overwhelming. And the apparently unanswerable question, how, echoes repeatedly through our minds. In the midst of these reflections, a photograph I took in the Alps catches my attention. Three children look out from a place and time in my past, but when I gaze at the image, I have the feeling it could equally be the future. Two of them watch me sphinx-like, as if waiting to see what I'll do. The third, caught in movement, suggests something as yet unknown, something uncertain and strange. I look at this picture and these children for a long time. Take off the mask, they seem to say. Take off the mask and see what lies beneath. Who are we really? Who are we when we take off these masks that the culture has designed for us and that we ourselves have molded around our hearts? Who are we when we return to our humanity? When we take the risk of really feeling and speaking of what is going on out there? And who are we when we allow ourselves to acknowledge our history, to name the present for what it is, and to actually seek the change that the future requires? Down here in